Well, what about you guys? How's it going? Hope you're all keeping well today. Hope everything is good where you are. So we're continuing on with the 5 reasons why you should use a certain editing software. How have you been finding it so far? Have you been using any of the things that we've talked about? Let me know in the comments down below some of your thoughts, sure. So far we've talked about Adobe Lightroom, Adobe Photoshop, and DaVinci Resolve. And the one thing those 3 softwares have in common is that we mostly use them on a computer-based system, whether it's a PC, laptop, MacBook, iMac, we mostly use them on there. But I actually wanted to come away from the computer for this one and talk about something that you can download onto your smartphone or your tablet. Now, I know, you're probably one of the ones that's sitting there saying, oh, smartphone photography isn't real photography. Well, you know, it pretty much is real photography, because anything you take photograph-wise is all to do with photography. And look at how much smartphones have come along over the years. I mean, I've been using the P20, and it's a phenomenal camera phone because I can do things like I can shoot in RAW, aperture, shutter speed. We've seen over the past couple of years, a lot of smartphones have actually started bringing in optical zoom, so being able to zoom in and zoom out, rather than digital zoom that's cropping into your shot or anything like that. Optical zoom is much more nicer on your photograph. And we wouldn't have ever thought of these sorts of things on camera phones at all, because before they used to just be like, you know, you had a photograph that was ridiculous, mate. It was pretty naff and all. Whereas now, it's really come a long way, and a lot more people are taking photographs on their phones than they are using a camera. And of course, if you go onto the Google Play Store or the Apple App Store, there's a mound of editing apps that you can download. So which one is the right one? Which one is the best one? Well, I'm going to talk about the one that I use, and it's one that I've used for a good number of years now, and I love it. I recommend it to anybody that is looking to do a lot of editing on their smartphone, and it's an app known as Snapseed. So today we're going to talk about 5 reasons why you should use Snapseed for all your smartphone photography. So let's get cracking then, shall we? So reason number one, and it's one that we've mentioned already so far, it can be downloaded onto most smartphones and tablets. So Snapseed is an app powered by Google, and again, you can just go onto your Play Store or App Store and just download this app just onto your smartphone or your tablet. They do say that you can download it onto your computer, but you have to download an emulator for an Android or an iPhone, so there's a little bit more things involved to get it on there, but you know, it's just a straight download onto your phone, and once it's there, it's there essentially. So it's just a little app that you open up, you can then start editing away on your photographs. It's an app that you can just take anywhere, because I can't take my laptop to every sort of place, whereas with this I can take it anywhere. Where I mean, like, say for example, like, we're not always going to bring cameras with us. You probably might find that you'd rather just lift up this guy than you would do like a camera. I mean, a few years back we went on a holiday to Mallorca, and I just took all my photographs on my phone. I had a P9 at the time, and still a great camera, and all I just did was take my photographs, edit them a little bit on Snapseed, and boom, I could just share them to Facebook or whatever I want, rather than having a camera, taking the photos, uploading it, you know, to a laptop or transferring to a phone. And you know, It's all there. It's all right there, and it just makes life so much handier. Reason number two, it's actually really user friendly. So the thing about the likes of Photoshop and Lightroom talked about before, you can see that there's so much that you can play about with. Well, there's a lot that you can play about with Snapseed, but the beauty about it is, with all touchscreen based devices now, is that you can just tap onto the things that you want. You can scroll up, down, left and right, and it'll just change to how your photograph is looking. Like, say for example, I've got this photograph open here of my in-law's dog Barney. Look at how cute he is, just so fast asleep. And all I'm just doing is just a quick edit here. So I'm going into brightness, contrasts, or whatever I want to. And you can see as I go along, as I swipe up and down, it gives me different options I can play about with. If I go left and right, it will then increase or decrease the amount of the option that I want. Reason number three, presets. So as you've seen me going along and doing all my manual editing, if you don't feel like doing anything like that, or if you're just starting off and you're not really too sure how a photograph might look if you do something, you're quite scared. But the beauty about Snapseed is there's a lot of presets that you can play about with. So even when you launch the app, you're given the different looks and the presets at the bottom as to just how you want your photograph. And you can just tap onto that, and if you like it, save it there. Boom, there's all your editing done in about 2 seconds. Or if you're wanting to do a little bit more on the editing, most of the sections in Snapseed will have a preset option, so the likes of, you know, curves, details, anything like that. Or my favorite part is the HDR scape. There's always a preset in there just to sort of give you a general idea, and you can put that preset in it and then just sort of play about with it as much as you want and maybe increase, decrease the amount that you want. So it still gets you a little bit more hands-on, but it gives you an idea of what that look might look like on your photograph. Now, reason number 4 I'm calling, no Photoshop, no problem. And the reason why I'm saying that is because we recognize the likes of Photoshop as being a really heavy-end photo editor, especially when it comes to things like cleaning up your images. If you do a lot of portrait work or anything, you would use Photoshop to get rid of blemishes, soften the skin, or get rid of any sort of dust marks or anything like that. It's a really good sort of healer. Well, the beauty about Snapseed is it's all there. You can see as I have this photograph of my ugly mug up on here, I'm just using the healer brush as I go along and just sort of getting rid of all the different sort of spots and dust marks on my shirt. Just to tidy up the image a good fair bit. Even outside of that, if I wanted to do a little bit more, what Snapseed has is if you do a lot of portrait work, there's things that can really help with how your portraits can look. I can go into the portrait option and it can actually open up options where I can smooth out the skin, brighten up the eyes or anything like that. So again, it's maybe not as sophisticated as what you could get out of Photoshop, but hey, it does a pretty good job. I mean, you can see from the photo I've been sharing here that just how beautiful I've made my skin. I mean, I've just turned 30. I'm getting old, so I am. But you can just see how just more softer I've made the skin, how much more brighter I've made the eyes. So reason number 5, and it's probably the best reason of all to get Snapseed on your phone, is that it is free of charge. So as the time of recording this video, and it has been for the past few years, Snapseed has been completely free. Before it was about, I think it was only about a fiver to download, whereas when Google took it on, they made it completely free of charge, and that just made downloads for the app skyrocket over the years. Snapseed, you can see just how much I was able to get out of this app, and all for nothing. No subscriptions, no one-off payments or anything like that. It is completely free of charge, and it's mental that you can just do all this here on this app, and this is why I have been using it for so long. So if you've been wanting something that you can download onto your smartphone or your tablet, and you've been wanting something that's quite user-friendly, a bit idiot-proof here and there, has some pretty good presets that you can play about with, and then you can do things that, you know, you can get out of Photoshop, but you don't want to go into the way of Photoshop, but don't want to spend any money or anything like that, well, Snapseed is probably the app for you. I've been using it for a good few years now, and I love it. It's really handy for if I just want to do a quick edit on my phone, stick it up online, and away you go. So what do you guys think? Do you use Snapseed, or what editing app do you like to use the most? Well, let me know in the comments down below. And of course, if there's something that you really like to see in this series, well, again, let me know in the comments down below. I do have something planned for next week. I'm not going to tell you what it is just yet. I'm going to keep it a little bit of a surprise. It's mostly because I'm going to be doing something completely different for it, but you know, you might like it, something a bit different. And of course, you'll only know about that video if you subscribe and hit that wee bell icon so that you can stay up to date with future videos. And also, don't be afraid to hit that wee like button too. So thanks once again, guys, for coming and check out my videos. Do take care of yourselves, and have a good day.